वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन सिग्नल एंड सिस्टम्स। वी आर स्टडीइंग फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म विच इज़ अ इंटीग्रल ट्रांसफॉर्म यूज टू रिप्रेजेंट नॉन पीरियोडिक सिग्नल्स। टुडे वी विल सी व्हाट इज़ द प्रॉपर्टी कॉल्ड एज डुअलिटी। ओके, सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर we have seen how to calculate Fourier transform for signal that is in time domain, which is a non-periodic signal represented here by xt. We can calculate Fourier transform and represent it through capital X omega. Okay, so capital X omega defines your Fourier transform and small xt defines your time domain signal. So this is in frequency domain. And it is in time domain. Okay. Now, what if we wanted to calculate Fourier transform for capital X T? Okay, so what if we are wanted to calculate the Fourier transform for capital X T, where omega is replaced by T? Okay, so if we replace omega by T, then capital X T का फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म क्या होगा? वी वॉन्टेड टू कैलकुलेट दिस थिंग. ओके, सो लेट अस सी क्विकली हाउ टू कैलकुलेट दिस यूजिंग प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ डुअलिटी. ओके, बिफोर गोइंग टू डुअलिटी प्रॉब्लम वी विल सी अनदर एग्जांपल एंड डिटरमाइन इट्स फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म. We are having an example two, where we wanted to calculate Fourier transform for xt, where small xt is equal to delta t. Okay, so according to our integral transformation, capital X omega is equal to minus infinity to positive infinity xt multiplied by e to the power minus j omega t. xt यहाँ पर डेल्टा टी के बराबर है एंड वी विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस सिग्नल बाय e to the power minus j omega t. And then we want to do integrate. After that, we will have the Fourier transform. Okay, so I am writing delta t as delta t minus 0. Because we can apply a property here to solve this integral through direct delta function. Okay, so you all know direct delta function. So we can quickly determine by replacing 0 with here. So t is replaced by 0 and we are having the integration. So this is a property for unit impulse. The answer will be e to the power minus j omega 0, which is equal to 1. So you have seen the Fourier transform for xt is equal to delta t, which is equal to 1. Now what we can determine is xt, that is e to the power delta t, the Fourier transform is x omega, which is equal to 1. Now we wanted to determine the Fourier transform for this function. Okay, so this will be determined through duality problem. And if we wanted to determine the Fourier transform for capital X t now, where t is replaced by omega, so it is equal to 1 also. Okay, so how can we determine Fourier transform for this function? So the property says, if we are having a signal xt, whose Fourier transform is given by x omega, we have replaced omega by t, then the Fourier transform for capital X t will be equal to 2 pi multiplied by x t, where t is replaced by minus omega now. Okay, so in brackets we will have small x minus omega. So this is the property of duality. Okay, so we will see how we can determine Fourier transform for 1, क्योंकि डेल्टा टी का फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म 1 है, तो 1 का फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म क्या होगा. ओके, सो लेट अस सी, वी हैव रिप्लेस्ड ओमेगा बाय टी, द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ कैपिटल एक्स टी विल बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ 2 पाई स्मॉल एक्स t replaced by minus omega. So xt is delta t, so we will replace delta t by omega, 2 pi delta minus omega, and as we know delta is a even function. 2 pi is equal to del 2 pi multiplied by delta omega is our final answer. Okay, so in this way we can use property of duality. Again we can see here what is duality. If xt has a Fourier transform x omega, capital X omega. Then if omega is replaced by t, then we wanted to calculate Fourier transform for this function. Okay, so capital X omega replaced by t, the Fourier transform will be 2 pi multiplied by small x t replaced by minus omega. Okay, so let us see one more problem here. Which is our example number 3. First, we will determine Fourier transform for xt, where xt is given by e to the power minus a mod t. Ut. Okay. So we want to determine Fourier transform for this function. If we see our signal here, this signal can be represented on the graph xt. This is plus time, this is negative time t. The signal is a exponential, so I can write xt as a signal e to the power minus a t for positive time, means when t is greater than 0, and e is equal to minus of minus t, that is plus a t for time less than 0. Okay. So quickly, we can plot on the graph. For positive time, the signal, if it's starting from here, will look like this. And for this part, it is a growing exponential from minus infinity to zero. So the signal will look like this. Now we wanted to calculate Fourier transform. So Fourier transform for xt, that is x omega, is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity xt e to the power minus j omega t xt. I have splitted the signal, so I can write the splitted signal now. E to the power at for time less than 0 multiplied by e to the power minus j omega t dt plus माइनस इन्फिनिटी टू इन्फिनिटी ई टू द पावर माइनस ए टी यू प्लस टी ई टू द पावर माइनस जे ओमेगा टी डी टी. ओके, सो आफ्टर सॉल्विंग दीज टू इंटीग्रल्स वी विल फाइंड द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म. सो इफ यू सी फॉर दिस पार्ट द लिमिट विल चेंज फ्रॉम माइनस इन्फिनिटी टू ज़ीरो एंड इन साइड ब्रैकेट वी आर हैविंग ई टू द पावर ए प्लस सॉरी ए माइनस जे ओमेगा टी डी टी प्लस दिस लिमिट चेंज फ्रॉम ज़ीरो से इन्फिनिटी बिकॉज यहाँ पे जो सिग्नल है वो यू टी है और यू टी एग्जिस्ट फॉर ज़ीरो टू टी टाइम. इन साइड ब्रैकेट वी आर हैविंग ई टू द पावर माइनस ए प्लस जे ओमेगा टी डी टी. द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इफ यू वॉन्टेड टू इंटीग्रेट दिस पार्ट देन इट इज इक्वल टू ई टू द पावर ए माइनस जे ओमेगा टी डिवाइडेड बाय ए माइनस जे ओमेगा एंड लिमिट फ्रॉम माइनस इन्फिनिटी टू ज़ीरो प्लस फॉर दिस पार्ट इट विल बी इक्वल टू ई टू द पावर माइनस ए प्लस जे ओमेगा टी डिवाइडेड बाय ए प्लस जे ओमेगा एंड लिमिट विल बी फ्रॉम ज़ीरो टू इन्फिनिटी. So after solving for limits, this part comes out to be 1 divided by a minus j omega and this part comes out to be 1 divided by a plus j omega. You can solve by yourself also and final answer you are having a plus j omega plus a minus j omega, that is 2a from j omega cancel out, 2a divided by now a square minus j omega square and finally we have two a divided by a square plus omega square. Okay, so this is our final answer. So now we wanted to calculate Fourier transform for xt where xt is equal to 2a divided by a square plus t square. In the previous example you have seen 2a divided by a square plus omega square is the Fourier transform for e to the power minus a mod t. यानि कि आपको अब जो given है वो is in the form of Fourier transform of something. Okay, where omega is replaced by t. Okay, so how will you calculate for this problem? Again we use property of duality. Okay, so if we use property of duality, so Fourier transform for capital X where T is equal to, where omega is equal to T, will be equal to two pi multiplied by small x, where T is replaced by minus omega, okay, where T is equal to minus omega. So in this way we are having our final answer, like for this signal, this is in the form of x omega, so I can write it as x t. Is equal to 2a divided by a square plus t square. Why I am writing this thing? Because if we are having small xt, which is equal to e to the power minus a mod t ut, the Fourier transform for the same is equal to capital X omega, which is equal to 2a divided by a square plus omega square. Okay, so now we will calculate the Fourier transform for X omega replaced by T. So first omega gets replaced by T, and we are having xt here, which is equal to 2a divided by a square plus t square. So Fourier transform for this signal is 2 pi multiplied by x t is equal to minus omega. So here in this signal we have to replace our t is equal to minus omega. Okay, so while we replace t is equal to minus omega, now then it is equal to 2 pi multiplied by e to the power minus a mod t, tha wahan pe hame dalna hai minus omega, which is equal to minus omega, and u t tha to yahan pe aa jayega u of minus omega. Okay, so finally we have answer, that is 2 pi e to the power minus a mod minus omega u minus omega. Okay, and this is our final answer for the Fourier transform of this signal. Okay, so likewise you have calculated your Fourier transform for the above signal. So I hope you will enjoy this video and you will remember the property of the duality. So this is all for today's lecture, and thank you very much.